So today I thought we'd do something a little bit different and do a what if involving the anime series One Piece. However, this is a bit different from a traditional what if you would see for one of these shonen theories, because it's more of a time travel redo question. But basically, what we're going to be asking ourselves today, what would happen if the Straw Hat Pirate from the Wano arc, which is currently on chapter 1034, redid the Summit War saga? So the premise is the following, that the Straw Hats, right now, as they are in Wano, would be affected of any injuries or anything. So just assume they're put back into full strength, they're restored. Assume they all have some senzu beans from Dragon Ball Z, which place it with themselves in the exact spot they were in right after Luffy punches Charlos in the face. So they're all in their current Wano body, they have all their abilities, and they all have the weapons that they have on their person with them. This does in fact mean that Franky, for example, would not have the Franky Shogun. He would have his updated new body from post-time skip, but none of the new vehicles or weapons he made that were on the study. Only their persons and the things that were on their persons are transported. So Zoro would have Enma. As they are switched place with their younger selves that were in canon, this also means that Jinbei is not with them. Jinbei had popped up and awoken and impaled down next to Porgot V8. So Luffy has punched Charlos in the face, and the Straw Hats are immediately faced with a pretty big problem even for their current Wano cell, which is the threat of Kizaru. However, the Straw Hats, realizing they are now in the path, immediately set out with a very straightforward goal of saving Luffy's brother, Porgot the Ace. However, that's pretty complicated. In fact, it could be argued that this is 10 times harder for them to pull off now in this scenario because of the fact that I don't think they're in nearly as much trouble in the moment on Thibodi as you would expect. First of all, the Pacifistas are no longer a threat to anybody on the crew. Nami and Usopp alone can one-shot a Pacifista at this point, so the Straw Hats already have an immense advantage. Also, this version of Zoro has no injuries, so they are at full power and the Pacifista will be no threat to them. They will also pretty easily be able to tangle with Kuma. While some of the lesser Straw Hats, like Nami or Usopp, won't be able to, Sanji alone should be able to handle Kuma with the power of Armin Haki being used to combat the power of the Paw Paw Fruit. The real issue, of course, comes down to Kizaru. However, with the Pacifista not being a threat, and any member of the Monster Trio at least being able to tangle with Kuma, I really don't see a scenario where the Straw Hats have any trouble getting away from here. Whether or not you want to say Luffy can 1v1 an Admiral isn't really relevant because he can definitely tangle with an Admiral on even footing for a long time now. With the kind of stuff we've seen Luffy pull off against Kaido, I mean, yeah, he's had a lot of help, but he's still fighting Kaido 1v1 and probably get a win at this point. So I'd be very surprised to see a scenario where Luffy can't hold off Kizaru while the others get away until Rayleigh shows up. I mean, once Rayleigh shows up and he holds off Kizaru for them to escape, then there's no threat, because nothing else besides for Kizaru is a threat to Luffy. At the very least, I'm pretty sure Luffy and Zoro and Sanji can beat Kuma. But unless all the Straw Hats put together, I'm pretty confident they're going to be able to take out Kuma, and with the Pacifista not being a threat and Kizaru being held off by Rayleigh, they're pretty much good. And even if Kizaru somehow manages to get past Rayleigh, the Straw Hats should be able to knock him away long enough to get to the Sunny and pull off the coup de burst. Escaping from Thibodi at the Palago isn't really difficult anymore, especially when you consider the whole point of the time skip once those stuff like that doesn't happen anymore. I don't see a situation where the Straw Hats just can't escape from the archipelago. But then we run into a much more complicated problem, which is, of course, the actual goal the Straw Hats will have, which is saving Ace. While power-wise, the Straw Hats are more than capable of steamrolling all of the Impel Down arc, Like, Magellan is nothing for the current Straw Hats. I'm sure Luffy, Zoro, and Sanji together could handle Magellan, and there isn't much else in Impel Down that would be that big a threat to the current Straw Hat Pirates. However, the problem isn't Impel Down itself, the problem is getting there, which is quite frankly impossible. You have to remember, the only reason Luffy was able to get into Impel Down was because Bo Hancock helped sneak him into Impel Down. Even for one of the Yonko, breaking directly into Impel Down would be incredibly difficult, just because your ship would probably be destroyed before you could even get there with the kind of defenses they probably had there, and sailing through the Calm Belt alone to get there would be exponentially difficult. Not to say the Straw Hats aren't more than capable of doing that. Between the Petals on the Sunny and the Coogee Burst, as well as the Straw Hats' ability to easily defeat the Sea Kings that will be in their path, getting to Impel Down in terms of sailing wouldn't be the problem. The problem would simply be getting through the Gates of Justice, arriving there, getting in through the door. All of that alone is simply too complicated. Because while the Straw Hats, as I've said, have the power to pull it off, the Sunny would simply be destroyed before it could get close enough to the prison for the Straw Hats to truly fight. They'd have to put way too much energy into protecting the Sunny and not fighting and breaking into Impel Down. Especially if Magellan came out and got involved, trying to prevent them from getting in, they wouldn't be able to fight Magellan and protect the Sunny at the same time. However, the Straw Hats have Franky, who is the best shipwright in the world, most likely, and they also have Nami, who is the best navigator in the world, and has enough knowledge of both the New World, Paradise, the Calm Belt, and any situation they have, that getting somewhere physically is no threat. They're powerful enough, then they're skilled enough, and they got Nami and Franky on their side. So the smart thing to do is do the same thing Whitebeard did. Just go directly to Navy headquarters and fight the Navy directly to take Ace back during his execution. The Straw Hats also have a massive advantage here because they right off the bat had the knowledge that the Navy plans to move up Ace's execution. However, while they have this knowledge, it is worth noting that the Straw Hats do lack something major that would have been very helpful in this conflict, with its influence and allies. Unlike in the present story, where I'm sure the Straw Hats could contact basically anyone if they really wanted to, could find a way to contact members of the Yonko, the Straw Hats have no way of just calling or contacting the Whitebeard Pirates. They also don't have the Grand Fleet or a lot of the New World nations that they would be allied with in the current storyline. They're not allied with the Minx or any of the New World countries that they're allied with now, such as Fifth Man Island or Dressrosa. They also lack the alliance with the Heart Pirates. The Heart Pirates, while maybe still willing to ally with the Straw Hats, are simply not equipped for any of the kinds of combat they would be seeing at Marineford. Asking law for an alliance or help in Marineford would simply be signing Law's death sentence. He would die instantly if he even attempted to compete with the kinds of threats the Straw Hats will be facing in Marineford. So they're down their alliance with Law, they're down their alliance with the Minx, and they're down their Grand Fleet. So Marineford would simply be the Whitebeard Pirates and the Straw Hat Pirates teaming up to save Ace. They would also be lacking the escaped prisoners from Impel Down, which would include Jinbei, which would mean that I assume the Straw Hat would need to eventually go, probably with more prep and time, save Jinbei from Impel Down. But as they are right now, they are simply not equipped to attempt something like that, especially without all their allies. So, while Luffy isn't the brightest tool in the kit, I do think it's pretty likely that him and the Straw Hats would come to the conclusion of using the same method of travel that Whitebeard did. Coat the Thousand Sunny and travel underwater and arrive at the Marineford alongside the Moby Dick. Now, this is where things get really, really complicated. Because now we have to ask ourselves, do the current Straw Hats minus Jinbei make enough of a difference that Ace can be saved? Now, it's important to remember that they did save Ace. Luffy did save Ace. He was successful, but Ace got himself killed, So the real question is, can the Straw Hat being there prevent such a scenario from happening? My answer to that, personally, is indeed an astonishing, easy yes. I don't actually think the Navy stands much of a chance here. The most important thing to establish with this question, at least in my opinion, is that the Straw Hats don't need to full-on win any of these fights. They just need to scuffle with these characters and come out alive and accomplish the goal of getting Ace out of Marineford alive. So, when I say Sanji can fight Kizaru, I don't mean Sanji needs to beat Kizaru to death with his legs. Sanji just needs to fight Kizaru and come out alive, which I think Sanji is capable of doing. He is probably capable of scuffling with Kizaru long enough to hold him off until someone else, since it's a member of the Whitebeard Pirate, can swoop in and continue the fight. None of the monster trio are getting one-shot by an admiral the way Luffy was. They are all capable of at least scuffling with admirals and tell a member of the Whitebeard Pirates who is stronger than them or at their level can come in and help them in that battle. It's also important to note that nobody is going to expect the Straw Hat to be this powerful. The admirals, Sengoku, Garp, they are going to be mind blown that the crew who struggled to defeat CP9 only a few weeks prior is now able to easily contend with the Admiral. Even for the One Piece world, which does see characters grow drastically in short periods of time, pre-time skip happens in less than a year, and Luffy goes from fighting Arlong to fighting Rob Lucci. But even for the One Piece world, as I said, this rate of growth is exceptional. It's mind-boggling. Nobody will be expecting the weaker members of the Straw Hat, like Nami, to be capable of one-shotting a Vice Admiral. So the first thing the Straw Hats are going to do when they arrive is Luffy is most likely going to go to the Moby Dick, jump on it, confront Whitebeard, tell him he could be Pirate King, and inform him that Ace's execution has been moved up. Whitebeard, being a seasoned pirate and master of observation, will probably realize very quickly that these Straw Hats are not rookies anymore. Particularly if Luffy decides to, when he tells Whitebeard he's going to be king, let loose some of the Conqueror's Haki and give Whitebeard a taste of what he's capable of, Whitebeard will probably realize that the Straw Hats are a massive power-up for them in this war. Then I think much of the war probably plays out pretty similarly. However, I think the Whitebeard Pirate, with the advantage of having the new Wano-level Straw Hats in their midst, are much more easily able to get to the point when they had to make a beeline for the execution platform. I don't think there's that much trouble getting through the gate or getting over barriers, and I don't think Orange Jr. necessarily needs to die, because I think between Whitebeard and Luffy together, especially Luffy, who's unlike Whitebeard, not thick and old, can probably take out any of the barriers the Navy sets up using Gear 3rd or Gear 4th. I do think it's likely that during this war, we would probably see a significant clash between Zoro and Mihawk, where Mihawk would probably comment to Zoro on his exceptional growth and how shocking it is, and Zoro may even comment something to kind of reveal that they're time travelers. But I don't think Zoro would probably let himself get distracted by Mihawk here. I can definitely see him telling Mihawk while they're having a brief clash that now is not the time for them to fight, that he is not concerned with Mihawk right now. That his only concern is saving Ace. Many of the Straw Hats probably consider not being there to help save Ace, not being there for Luffy when he needed them, one of their greatest failures in life. So I can see many of them taking this incredibly seriously. And I don't see any of them joking around or letting themselves get distracted by any nonsense. I think their only goal throughout this entire war would be save Ace. However, there is a possibility that Bo Hancock would not attend the Paramount War in this scenario. If Bo Hancock doesn't go to Marineford, that changes everything. That gives the Whitebeard Pirates and the Straw Hats a major advantage. Because in this timeline, Luffy and Boa don't meet, so Bo Hancock would be an enemy of the Straw Hats and would be a massive threat if he took the war seriously. However, there's also the possibility if he goes through with her original plan of not showing up, which I think is more likely. both Hancock did show no interest in attending the war and was adamant that her opinion was no until Luffy changed her mind. So in this scenario, there is no Bo Hancock to worry about. Which does probably mean that in this timeline, Bo Hancock would have her warlord status revoked 2 years earlier. But with the Straw Hats able to handle most, if not all, of the enemies they see, especially the warlords, let's be honest, Luffy's one-shotting Gecko Moria at this point. The real question here is, do characters like Doflamingo get more involved? Even if they do, I think current Luffy, hot take here, can probably one-shot Doflamingo. He was really ragdolling him once he was in Gear 4 during Dressrosa, and Luffy had gotten much, much better at using Gear 4 since then. So then the only warlord that really matters here is Mihawk, who is of course probably going to be tussling with Zoro, Vista, and other members of the Whitebeard Pirate. But I'm assuming if Zoro ignores him and focuses on saving Ace, Mihawk probably would put as much effort into the war as he did originally, which didn't seem to be much, meaning Mihawk probably not a threat either. The Navy will also probably lose a lot of their foot soldiers. Meanwhile, Whitebeard seems to be struggling due to his age to use Conqueror's Haki. Luffy's not going to have that problem. So at the bare minimum, we know the Marines will be losing like 50,000 fighters, because Luffy can take out 50,000 father characters with a Conqueror's Haki as seen in Fifth Man Island, which he can probably take out more than that at this point in time. Also, I'm sure Luffy's ability to use Conqueror's Coding to punch a Logia without actually making physical contact with them will be very helpful in any scuffles he has with Akainu. While they will be lacking Mr. 3 here, I don't think they need Mr. 3 because in this universe, they have Nami on their side. And I'm sure Nami, if she's as determined as she would be in this scenario because Ace's life is on the line and with what she owes to Luffy and how incredibly loyal she is to Luffy, would be more than willing to make a beeline to steal the key to Ace's handcuffs. And let's be honest, Nami can pull it off. If anybody can sneak in there and steal that stuff, it's Nami. In fact, Sanji could probably even transport Nami to where she would have to go deeper in Marine Board to steal the key using a combination of Geppo and his insane speed. He could probably pull it off without even being noticed. Get Nami to where she needs to be, and then she can go do her cat burglar thing, steal the keys, and Ace can be free. We know the people who have the keys aren't like admirals. They're just regular guards. So Nami will have no problem stealing from them, and if it comes down to it, she can just sneak up to them and beat the ever-living crap out of them, take the keys, and then all she needs to do is get them to the platform when Luffy arrives there. Luffy would fight his way to the platform, Nami would probably be there with the keys, she could give him the keys. At the same time, I imagine Usopp would be like on the Sunny, sniping a ton of the father characters that were a little too strong to be taken out by Conqueror's Haki. And then I can imagine Zoro and Sanji would be tangling with the Admirals or other high-level Marines. The Whitebeard Pirates would just be fighting anyone they could. Whitebeard would probably be tangling with one of the Admirals as well, if not an Admiral. I could imagine maybe in this scenario, Sengoku may get involved, and maybe Whitebeard would end up having a scuffle with Sengoku, which would be wild and epic as all hell. And I don't really think Garp needs to get involved here. I think Garp deep down did want them to save Ace, and I don't see Garp attacking any members of the Straw Hat. I especially don't see him attacking Luffy. When he was forced to attack Luffy, when it was going to happen during the war, he couldn't bring himself to do it. And when Ace actually died, he was ready to kill Sazuki. And I think it's incredibly likely that Garp would have a very similar stance in this conflict. He would probably just sit with Ace and laugh hysterically at how awesome the Straw Hats are and how proud he is of Luffy. Now, if the Straw Hats and the Whitebeard Pirate can free Ace, which I think, thanks to the fact that any of the missing escapees from Impel Down can be made up for either by the increase in power the Straw Hats have, or somebody like Nami who was able to steal the key And I also don't think Baki would be destroyed as easily this time. Because I don't think Kizaru could as easily get the drop on Luffy now that he has Future Sight. So once Ace is freed, then I don't think there's really any obstacle at all. The version of Luffy that is fighting in this war would probably not be nearly as tired, beat up, or weakened, especially because he has had so much support from the Straw Hat. He's also had access to Chopper to treat any injuries he may have gotten. But even more than his access to Chopper, he's also not had to invade Impel Down and receive several hormone ingestions from Ivanka. He's simply not as weakened as he was during the war in canon. He's also much stronger now. So, we have to remember, while Ace did partly die because he turned around to fight Akainu and defend Whitebeard's honor, it's important to note that that's not actually what killed him. He was losing that fight, but what killed him was having to take the blow for Luffy when his body finally gave out, which at this point in the war probably wouldn't happen because it would be a session of a couple scuffles with the admirals and a few of the members of the warlords like Mihawk or maybe Doflamingo. There isn't really anyone who is on Luffy's level to the point when he needs to really worry. He'd mostly be able to take most people out with Conquerors or a few basic punches or even a couple minor uses of Gear 2nd for maybe some of the Vice Admirals. But he's definitely not at the point when he needs to use 3rd Gear to like take out Giants, and he's exhausted just from fighting minor Marines that hold the rank of like Vice Admiral. You remember, Luffy at Marineford was so out of his league, a lot of the time it was just the number of people, and he was struggling against even some of the Vice Admirals. So, when Ace challenges Akainu, there are really two outcomes. One, Ace had the fight with Akainu, and Luffy kind of just lets it play out, and then when Ace is about to lose, Luffy gets involved and start fighting Akainu until more members of the Whitebeard Pirates show up and help him hold off Akainu while some other members of the Whitebeard Pirates or the Straw Hats carry Ace to safety, who at this point has been defeated. Or Luffy intervenes right away and him and Ace team up to fight Akainu until reinforcements arrive. Either way, there is no scenario here where Luffy, who is much stronger than Ace, needs to be saved by Ace from Akainu in this fight. Luffy's not beating Akainu, but all he really needs to do is hold him off long enough for more members of the Whitebeard Pirates to show up and tussle with him. Eventually, what will most likely happen if Whitebeard will decide to make his sacrifice, and then the Whitebeard Pirates, along with Ace, who I'm assuming at this point had probably his body had given out and he's probably being carried by Luffy or a member of the Straw Hat to the Whitebeard Pirate, would be taken onto the Moby Dick or the Thousand Sunny. Whitebeard would make a sacrifice. Blackbeard would show up. And I can imagine things at that point, once Ace is saved, play out pretty similarly. However, at this point, here comes the real question. If Whitebeard still dies, Blackbeard still shows up, all of that still happened, but the Whitebeard Pirates managed to save Ace. They managed to get him on the Moby Dick. Whitebeard dies while he defends them so they can escape. That all still happened. And then, of course, Blackbeard shows up. Whitebeard died. He takes Whitebeard Gorogoro no Mi. Then we're left with the question of, does Shanks showing up stop the war? On one hand, the Marines have a massive W in the fact that Whitebeard is dead. But he's also proclaimed that One Piece is real in front of the entire world, Ace has escaped, and things aren't looking very good for them. However, you also have the unavoidable fact that they're not winning this war because of the fact that Ace has escaped. They had the Straw Hat and the Whitebeard Pirates who have been kicking their asses, or at least contending with them, and now Shanks, the captain of the Red Hair Pirates, is here, and he's ready to fight at full power. At this point, you have the Straw Hat, who are a nearly Yonko level, if not a Yonko level crew. You have the Whitebeard Pirates without Whitebeard and Red Hair Shanks. If you want to assume that Luffy is on the low tier of Yonko level, if he's like the weakest character to hold that title, then you basically have two Yonko level fighters in Luffy and Shanks. You have the Whitebeard Pirates, which are the crew of a Yonko. You have the Red Hair Pirates, who have a crew of a Yonko and are not injured at all, and you have the Straw Hat Pirate, who are the crew of a Yonko level fighter in the form of Luffy. Now, this is where I'm going to lean into a bit of speculation, but I do believe that whatever it was that let Shanks meet with the Gorosei during the Reverie, it's the same thing that caused Sengoku to so quickly relent to Shanks about letting him take Whitebeard's and Ace's bodies and letting the war end. Sengoku specifically says in the war that he's only letting this happen because it's Shanks. So even though it's a pretty bad look for the Navy, I do think, considering how just messy everything is, considering they're dealing with the Straw Hat, the Whitebeard Pirates, the Red Hair Pirates, considering they've already managed to kill Whitebeard, considering they've dealt with the Straw Hat appearing out of nowhere and being like a billion times stronger, and just how much more messy this war has been, I think it's very likely that while looking at the forces of the Whitebeard Pirates, the Red Hair Pirate, and the Straw Hat Pirate, Sengoku would decide to, like in canon, just let the war end, with poor guy the Ace escaping with the Whitebeard Pirate and the Straw Hat Pirate leaving Marineford, as well as the Red Hair Pirate going away as well. In this scenario, Luffy and Shanks would also meet again. Or it's also possible that they just briefly cross paths, but they do not interact in any major way, because Shanks and Luffy just aren't ready yet. So in this scenario, Ace stays alive, but Whitebeard still dies, and Blackbeard probably still becomes a Yonko. However, now the Straw Hat have to go, one, rescue Jinbei, and then I assume go into the new world and continue on their same goal of, I guess, defeating Kaido, gathering the Road Poneglyph, and reaching Laugh Town. So in this fictional what-if scenario, you actually have a very interesting new universe, where the Straw Hat Pirates are a massive force in the world post-Marineford, and are immediately going to stage a breakout of Impel Down, and then immediately jump into the new world with no time skip for training, because they don't need it. This would shake the world drastically. You would see multiple things change. We may even see Luffy claim Fifth Man Island as his territory before Big Mom claims it, which may change the events of Wano entirely. This is a fascinating scenario to cover, and I think I may do a part 2 to this video going over what happens after that. Talking about the Straw Hat breaking into Impel Down, and then maybe how this new world is affected by the events of Marineford and what the Straw Hats do upon rescuing Jinbei. There are so many interesting angles this what if could take, and I had a lot of fun recording this and just thinking through how different the war would go. And I think analyzing how this changes future story beats and the politics of the One Piece world would be a lot of fun. So let me know what you think would happen if this scenario took place in the comment section down below. Like the video if you enjoyed it. And above all else, guys, have a great day. This is NerdKing101 signing out. And remember to subscribe for more videos like this one, especially considering I'm promising a part 2 and part 3 probably right here, right now.